To help me make the point about what a digital image is, here I've taken a sample image of the Georgia Tech mascot, Buzz, and of course his wonderful, colorful glory here. What we're interested in now actually start looking at and teasing apart various aspects of an image, for example, a square image like this one. Just to help us along, I've actually converted this image into a grayscale image, which basically means that the whole image is now represented not in color, but just the different aspects of the gray values of an image, basically the range from a white pixel or a white color to a black color. And this basically now is showing a black and white or a grayscale image. Now, mostly, we will be looking at these images and trying to represent them in a coordinate space. Here I'm referring to the X and Y coordinate space, which basically allows us to be able to traverse this image in this axis, which is X, and in this axis, which is Y. And the interest in doing this is because now I'll be able to kind of count down in some instances, if you start thinking of this as basically different columns and different rows of the image. So I'd go down each and every column until I come here, wrap around, and I would actually start looking for other columns going down row by row. So this is one of the representations we want to start looking at, and how do we best kind of represent an image in a form that allows us to, in a raster scan format, traverse each and every element of that image. So now that we know the axes of this image, let's look at the dimensions of this image. So here I show you the whole box that represents this image. And of course, the easiest way to reference this box would be the width and the height of the image. Width represents the number of columns that would exist in this image, and the height represents the number of rows that represent this image. This is a square image, a classic image, and each the basic width of this image is 512 pixels, and the height is 512 pixels. And if you just do the simple math of trying to take 512 width and 512 pixels height, you basically get an image that has about 262,000 pixels, and this converts it into a 0.26 megapixel image, and this is an approximate number of megapixels this image has. So this is basically one of the ways of the simplest ways of representing an image, where we need to know the width and the height and how we'd be traversing it.